and welcome back to another episode of Matt's Workshop. It seems to be a long time since we last spoke to each other on the camera. I think it was July when I last released a video, and here we are now. It's the 10th, Saturday, the 10th of October, 2020. A lot of things have gone on over the last few weeks. I made my comeback in racing. Sadly, not in hot rod racing, but I made my comeback in 1/8 Rallycross. There's my 1/8 Rallycross car here, already getting prepped up for its meeting over at Ada a week on Sunday. However, this film is all about hot rod racing. As you remember, back in July, I'd built the National Hot Rod, was all set to join HOTS down in Haversheath. They weren't accepted new members due to the COVID restrictions and the fact they couldn't access their regular venue. I put the hot rod on eBay, and within a couple of days, somebody got in touch saying, "I've seen your videos on YouTube. I love your car. I want to buy it. What are you going to use the car for?" I said. He goes, "I just want to terrorise people up and down the street with it." Fair enough. The car was sold. Guy picked the thing up and he was really, really impressed with it. I was due to go on holiday for a couple of weeks. Just before I left, one of the committee from HOTS got in touch saying, "Well, we'd like to vote you on as a member at our forthcoming AGM. How would you think about it?" "Yes, I'd love to." Got back in touch, was voted on at the AGM, and I got voted on. Great. I'm ready to race a National Hot Rod. Minor problem, I don't have a car anymore because I've just sold it. Just after that, one of the guys at HOTS got back in touch saying, "If you want to buy a car, I'm selling my hot rod." A rendezvous was arranged for a couple of days later down in a McDonald's car park near Uckfield. And a second-hand National Hot Rod, all ready to race, including the servo, the speed control, literally everything you need to go, is sitting here. So, what is the new car, you're probably asking? It's a Camtec car like it was before. It's all been built up. Tom raced the car, I believe, quite successfully. Had a look at the car. It's usually been built to a very, very high standard. So let's have a quick unveiling and see how she looks. Ta-da! It's exactly the same shell we had back on at the summer. The only thing different is the car that's under the skin. Just have to take the cover off and we'll just have a quick look at it. So here are the cars. That's a 1/8 Rallycross car on the left-hand side. That's all ready to go. I'll do a 1/8 Rallycross film in a couple of weeks' time, I think. In the meantime, let's have a look at the National Hot Rod. It's got the Camtec Fiesta shell on it, just like the previous car had on it. It's got my name on it, ready to go. Wheels and tyres are on it. Let's have a quick look under the skin. So here's the car under the skin. We've got my turn G receiver in there. We've got the personal transponder base down in there. I don't know if that's going to view in or not. That's about it there. Got a massive 8,200 mAh LiPo in there, which I'm told you only need to take one battery with you to a hot rod meeting these days, and just gently peek the thing up in between heats. And we've got a 13.5 turn brushless motor in there. Everything's got the sensors on there. All the corner weights are all on there. So hopefully when we get the car to the track and we put it on the track, we'll be all ready to go. No one's having any practice at the moment. It's just a case of get in there. The track's going to be set up. Well, they're probably putting the track in tonight. Get up, get down to the track, go onto the track, do some racing, no practice, three heats and the final. Should be wrapped up early afternoon. It's going to be a busy day and I'm looking forward to it. Not quite sure how the car or I are going to handle. I haven't raced on an oval since early 2018, but yeah, we'll just have to see what happens. That's about it for now. In the meantime, I'm going to go to bed. It's nearly 11 o'clock. I've got an early start tomorrow. I've got to get the car loaded up, head down to HOTS for a 9:30 entry fee. We'll get to the track. We'll unload and see what happens there. No need to worry about the weather for this one because thankfully HOTS is an indoor track. I'm not quite sure what's going to happen today. Car's loaded up, all the batteries are charged, the equipment's ready to go. I haven't raced on an oval since, early 2018, so I'm going to be a bit rusty. There are some very, very top drivers racing today. Some of them, I think there's a couple of former world champions turning up. I don't know if Dexter Bergman's booked it in or not, but we'll know when we get down there. Still, hopefully it's going to be a good morning, good afternoon, good evening's good afternoon's racing. And we'll see what's going to happen from there.
So, it's Monday night. Nearly 36 hours after we started racing yesterday. 36 hours since we left here. Just unloaded the car. Got the car onto the bench. It's a bit battle-scarred. The racing was good. It was fast and furious. I don't think I've ever made such an improvement in the course of a meeting. I think I started off in the first heat. I did 48, 49 laps in the first heat. And I think it was either 79 or 80 by the time I finished the final. Car handled like a stuck pig in the first heat. I eliminated the problem. There was one of the front wheels was dragging. Keith Smith, one of the guys, they're very, very kindly lent me a set of new tyres, a spare of second-hand tyres, a set of KSEs, because the rear tyres were worn. And then a guy called Harry Weymouth gave me a hand to set the car up, and both guys gave us some good advice. So thanks, Jess, it's much appreciated. Job to do now is to strip the car down, look it over, and clean it up, ready for the next race. In the meantime, let's just quickly go upstairs and look at the heat-by-heat results, and I'll talk you through what happened and how it went. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to do any filming in the hall. It would have been lovely to have been able to film some of the racing, etc., but the guys at the club asked us not to, because the last thing they want to do is see somebody not wearing a face mask and end up being losing the hall again after all the work they've done to get us back in there and up and racing again. That's perfectly fair enough. So let's go and have a quick look at Sunday's results, and then I'll strip the car down and we'll prep it ready for its next meeting.
So in qualifying round one, and that's the first time I'd driven an RC car on an oval in nearly 3 years, I managed to hit 39 laps with a best lap time of 3.99 seconds. The car was handling like a stuck pig at that point, mainly because I had no grip on the rear end due to running some fairly worn out tyres. And also I discovered after the race that the front right wheel had been pinching, which was dragging the car into the corners. After round one, I made some adjustments to the car. Keith lent me some decent tyres to go on the back, and it made a lot of difference. So back out in round two, I managed to finish fifth out of six drivers, which wasn't bad going at all. I hit 66 laps from 39, which was a massive, massive improvement. And again, the best lap time had dropped down to just over 3.5 seconds, which was absolutely amazing. The car felt a lot better then. I couldn't just drive the car, I could race it. There was a lot of traffic flying around, which was good fun. Everybody had calmed down a bit by then, and everyone was getting their cars dialed in again and was getting back into the groove. What would be better in qualifying round three? Round three was even better than ever. I went up to 69 laps, yet another improvement. Best lap time, 3.42 seconds, and I finished fifth again. I was absolutely amazed that I kept getting these places. I was honestly expecting to be trailing around at the back, but hey-ho, qualifying out of the way, how would we fare in the final? The final started off at an absolutely cracking pace. Morgan Williams charged it into the lead. A couple of times I didn't get spun out, but I ended up going off the main racing line, and it took me a while to get back into the groove. Best of all, though, I got fourth in the overall final, with the best lap time of 3.33 seconds, hitting 79 laps. So that's like 40 laps. That's a 40 lap improvement since it was in heat one. Wow, what could I say? Anyway, that's enough of me waffling on about how well I did or how well I didn't do on Sunday. Let's go back downstairs to the workshop and start looking over the car.
So let's have a quick look around the car. This is exactly as it was as it came off the track after the final on Sunday. You've got a few scuff marks down on the front wing. We've got a lot of tyre debris that's come flying off the wheels all over the bodywork. It rode the Armco a few times, but all looks okay again. Front end looks okay. Again, had a few bumps and scuffs, but yeah, nothing that won't polish out. There's a bit of tyre chunking on there, but for the next meeting I'll put some new KSEs on there. And we have around the back. Yeah, that looks okay as well. Let's drop the skin off and see how she is underneath her shell. Again, under the skin, there's a bit of chunking on the outside tyre. Plenty of debris coming off the front tyres, but then again, I'd expect that. A lot of tyre debris and all that. Racing was pretty hard on the tyres on Sunday. Front servo and the wishbones all look okay. Again, I can't praise this car enough for the resistance of it. My old Schumacher Super Sox Atom would have just broken apart after the abuse that was thrown at this car on Sunday. The build quality and the strength of this car is absolutely amazing.
Rear tyres, that was chunked before it went on there, which is Keith Gaveman, that's fine. Again, just looks like a bit of dust and a bit of dirt in there. Nothing that won't brush away or polish out. Battery needs to come off and be cycled through. I was just going to strip the car down, clean it up and re-oil and re-grease everything, ready for the next meeting, which is on November the 8th. Just going to push the rear bearings out because I don't want those to be blown away when I put the airline on this and tick, tick. The eagle eyes are much most, and I've got two sets of tools that I'm using. The Turnergy tools and these are other multicolour tools. It's the Turnergy one. Unfortunately, I've got a set of tools for both nitro and electric, so I use the Turnergy tools on the electric. And when I'm building drones, I tend to keep these other tools for nitro. I just give them a wash every now and then just to degrease them and keep them clean. That way you don't end up with filthy hands. Right, let's give this thing a quick blow off. Right, that'll do for now. Front and wheel bearings here, they just go straight into a pickling pot. Yuck. Ooh, nice and oily, nice and carpety. Yuck, 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 yuck. That quick spray off. Yeah, get the solution around in there nicely. Give them a quick clean up. Brush. That's got all the crap off, and you can see inside the pot, and you can probably call that, so I should have used a white lid, but that solution was clear when I started. It's now gone this horrible, like, muddy grey colour. I must apologise for the state of my bench here. If my old boss at the Formula One company saw the state of my bench here, he would go ballistic. This really needs to be clean, but I've got so much going on at the moment. The stuff I'm buying and selling on eBay, RC stuff's going, coming and going like the wind. There, that's got the bearings cleaned up and they're now ready to go back in the car. Yeah, these are the clamp tyres that I was using to start with. You can see they've lost a lot of their natural moisture. I'll just try and get that in focus on the camera. I had absolutely no grip with those at all. And once we put the KSEs on, it was like driving a different car. Yeah, you can just see they just started to dry out. So that's basically the car stripped down, cleaned up, and it's all ready to go now for the next meeting on the 8th of November. I'll clean the shell up a little bit with some acetone. polished off most of the scuff marks. There's no point spending hours on it because within two or three laps of the next race, it'll all be scuffed up again. Let's get the shell back on. And that's it. Job done. The car's been raced. It's been brought back here, stripped down and cleaned, and she's all ready to go again.
So, here's the National Hot Rod ready to go. The race bay is now full. The 1/8 nitro buggies are here, ready for the weekend's racing. Just got to prep them over and check them over. There's not that much needs to be done to them this weekend. They were both prepared for a meeting at Ada a couple of weeks ago, which unfortunately fell victim to the weather on the day before the meeting. So I've just really got to check them over, run the engines up, make sure all the nuts and bolts are tight and everything, and then we'll be ready to go. A lot of people ask me why I take two cars to a 1/8 rallycross meeting. These cars, that car's a nice and simple car to work on. These things aren't. These are a bit like rebuilding a three-dimensional jigsaw puzzle. If I break something on, that's my main car, the red one. If I break something on that, the chances are I won't have time to repair it for my next heat. So I literally just jump straight on the spare car. I assess the damage, and if I can't fix it, I jump straight onto the spare car, which is geometrically the same. It's got exactly the same engine, same radio gear, same servos. Just need to reprogram my transmitter, and then off I go again. Hopefully this return to hot rod racing video has been of interest. I'll probably do a rallycross video at some point in the future. Hopefully, if you're watching this and you see me at Ada on Sunday the 18th of November 2020, do come up and say hi. Or keep an eye out for the next video, which I'll do probably after HOTS on the 8th of November. In the meantime, stay safe, happy racing. Bye-bye for now.